So as that last quiz just showed us, in order to figure out whether an expression is true or not, or what it evaluates to, we're going to need to keep track of the values of variables, which might change with assignment statements. So we're going to track the current state of the world. Is X1 or is X2? We don't know yet. Is the King of France bald or not? We're going to have to find out. It's a question that can be answered empirically by looking at the state of things. So to figure out what an expression like X+2 means, when we're doing our interpreting, when we're writing our web browser, we're going to need to keep around some notion of the values of variables, the state of the world. And we're going to do that with a mapping from variable names, like x, to values. In Python dictionary style, that might be something like x currently has the value 3. This mapping is called the state, and this is a super important concept in programming languages. It's kind of like asking, what's the current temperature? Depends on the current state of the world, and it may change over time. We'll need a lot of bookkeeping to keep track of it. So as we hinted earlier, a fairly direct way to do this would be just to use a Python dictionary that maps strings, variable names, to values. If we had something like this, we could easily evaluate x times y in this context, in this state, and determine that it's true for this state. Right now x is 2, right now y is 3, 2 times 3 is 6. So the value of this expression is true if this is the state of the world. Now, later we may want our environment to be a little more complicated than just a single Python mapping, so we're going to introduce an abstract function to query it. So we'll just make a promise to ourselves. We're going to write a function called environmentLookup, where you pass in an environment, probably a dictionary, but we may make it more complicated later, and a variable name, and you get the answer out. So if this is our environment E, calling env lookup of this environment E and asking for the variable y gives us back the value 3.